full video, right? It will get hung in the middle. Let's go and select the healing brush. I saw some spots on our face like this one. All we have to do is like make it similar so that from outside it won't see as a difference. Simple healing brush. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah? Very simple. There's nothing else you need to do for healing brush. So wherever you see a difference, just go and put this on top of it. You can also drag it like this. Okay? If you don't have patience, you can just drag it like that. But sometimes it will get you a negative result, so be careful. Okay? Because if I'm going to drag it like this, right? See? Okay? I'm going to drag it like this, see? Okay, so sometimes you have to be pretty careful about dragging. But yeah, more or less it works fine. You just need to change the location. Okay, this is the clones sampling tool. So I'll take a sample from here, Alt. Do you see the target? Clicking on the location and then that's it. There's nothing else you need to do. It spreads all the color over here. You can also do crazy things like this.
Be like helpful when we have to create more clouds in the landscape.
Yeah, exactly. I use that for that only. I've created such one picture where I created something stupid. wait, hold on, I'll show you. It was one of the. This I made
up. Okay.
It was not like this, but I just, you know, added sampling over that, and then I made something like this. It's not the best, but we took it with a wide-angle camera.
Okay.
GoPro. So that's why it is like distorted. Do you see the distortion here?
Yeah.
So this is what I'm talking about, the turning over here. But it was not. It was actually straight. But just the lens is like that, which. When you take it from minimum, it makes it distorting and somewhat beautiful as well.
Yeah.
Okay. From her perspective, this lady looks damn good because the surroundings are like coming really nice. So that's all this. Okay. So yeah, so such an effect you can make it in terms of this thing. So anyways, what else? So this is done. And the smudge tool, this is the eraser tool, this is the eraser, the background, okay. If you don't want without background, the background eraser tool where it removes the background, you get a transparent image.
Okay.
Remember, transparent image is nothing but just her face and body, no background. Okay. And another one is like magic eraser tool where you touch one thing, all blackness is gone. Not a very great feature to use at this point of time because there's so much blackness everywhere. Okay, this is the paint bucket gradient tool and other stuff, just to paint on a specific layer. And then you have this smudge tool, sharpen tool, and blur tool.
Okay.
So you'll get this thing where you can increase the size of the brush and then you can blur a specific area. Okay, and then you have smudge tool to smudge a specific area. I don't know how long it's gonna go. I think it's done.
Is it that liquify effect, what we call it?
Huh.
Or is that a different thing?
Liquidify it? No. This much.
Okay.
That's different. And then dodge tool is basically to brighten a place. Burn tool is to darken a place. And sponge tool is like, it kind of creates spots in the picture. Where we put the sponge. This is pen tool to write something. And this is a freedom pen. You can just write anything. Like, so basically, like, you can just write anything on the picture. This is text tool. You can write some text on the picture and stuff. And this is the arrow mark tool to select a path or select a location. And then this is the different type of boxes you can make it. Or if you're writing something on that, you can write it in, say, these boxes. You can make the boxes colory stuff. They're using Photoshop for designing rather than editing a picture. Then you can use all these designing stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And this is your hand tool, just to use the hand to navigate to different pictures or something. So, and then there is a little more option over here. I think that's the end of it. So this is what it is. This is the left side collection. This is the foreground color, background color.
Mm-hmm.
You can also change it. Or change the color, foreground and background. Okay, so you can just use that. So these are the options you're gonna get in for each of these tools on the top. On the right side, very important, we are already on history. We can go back, but only hundreds of corrections, 500 I think, corrections you can do. But beyond that 500 corrections, you cannot do that. Okay, so we can go to the original picture. So if you modify anything over here, all this 500 corrections will be gone. You can remember that. So you can get the difference from here to there. So, so this is how it's done. Okay. So next thing is like, we will see how to, the layers I'll tell you. Layers is basically like you have a picture. Okay. On top of the picture, you want to draw another picture. Same picture you want on top of that. So you put something called a colorless paper on top of it and draw something on it. If you don't like it, throw it, put another paper. Same thing happens over here. Don't apply any changes on top of this picture. Okay? First, add a layer and add those changes to this layer. I'll tell you. Hello?